Most recently, the idea of quantum fields has become a prominent discussion in what is called quantum field theory. So, in quantum field theory, what we call particles are just excitations of the field, fluctuations of the field. This framework describes particles as disturbances or fluctuations or excitations within the underlying quantum fields. For example, the electron is seen as an excitation of the electron field. And today, science describes many specific particles, but remember, particles don't have any inherent existence in themselves. They just describe a moment of excitation in the field itself. Fermions, they make up matter. Electrons, quarks, which form protons and neutrons. Bosons, these carry forces. For example, photons carry the electromagnetic force, gluons, the strong nuclear force, W and Z bosons, the weak nuclear force, the Higgs boson, which gives mass to particles. And then there's a hypothetical a particle called graviton, a virtual graviton, which is thought to be the force of gravity, but it hasn't been observed. Okay, so now just let's see the quantum field and try and relate it to the consciousness field. I know I'm obsessed with this, so I'm just sharing it with you. This might not be interesting at all to you, but the quantum field is giving rise to all what we now think is energy and matter. And of course, information is embedded in the energy field. But look at what non-dual consciousness says. You know, this idea comes from Advaita, and it also comes from Buddhism, and it comes from the non-dual traditions, which don't speak obviously of the consciousness field, but they speak of experience in the field. So consciousness in that framework is a fundamental unified field rather than a product of the brain or individual mind. Fluctuations in consciousness are things like sensations, sense perceptions, images, feelings, and thoughts. Think of all of them as sensations, because sensations, perception, sound sensation, color sensation, hard, soft sensation, etc. You know, taste, flavor sensation, olfactory sensation, thought sensation, image sensation, emotional sensation. These are transient fluctuations within the consciousness field. And like the virtual particles, they are impermanent. They emerge and dissolve, just like the virtual particles. So, principle analogous to quantum uncertainty governs the appearance of these fluctuations, the appearance and the disappearance of these fluctuations. This implies an inherent unpredictability within consciousness. Also, just like particles are in superposition before they are observed, before being experienced, sensations exist in a state of superposition within the consciousness field, meaning they have the potential to manifest in multiple ways. So you can see the correlation between what is objectively described as the quantum field and what is experienced subjectively as the consciousness field. Except even the objective correlates that we see in the quantum field first have to be experienced in the consciousness field, and then we give them names once we observe them. But once we observe them, where is the experience of that happening? Where is the experience of the electron happening? Experience. before you label it there, you give it a name there. The experience of the electron is happening in awareness. So before we observe a particle, as we said, it exists in superposition, and the same thing is with every sensation. Before we observe it, it is in superposition, and it has the potential to manifest in multiple ways. So here comes an important principle, and this is the uncertainty principle. When we delve deeper into what this uncertainty principle is within consciousness, then we realize that there are many possibilities to consider. Is it random? Does it relate to our everyday experience? Does it imply that our choices and perceptions shape the fluctuations that manifest? So the correlation between consciousness and the quantum field is actually quite obvious. And there may be a more fundamental reason for this, what we call the uncertainty principle. So the uncertainty principle says you cannot predict with accuracy the next space-time event. Now, I'd just like to make one suggestion. What we call fluctuations in consciousness, sensations, images, feelings, thoughts, perceptions, entangled, these are also in yoga, they're called vrittis, which means excitations, fluctuations, vibrations. So consciousness is vibrating as experience. And then we actually create a model from that experience, and we call it the quantum field. The quantum field is the model created by giving names and labels to subtle sensations, whether we observe them through the ultrastrobic, stroboscopic microscope or hadron collider, whatever. We are observing a fluctuation which seems to be out there, but actually it's a space-time event in consciousness. So then if we understand this, that the whole universe and everything in it is a combination of these fluctuations, let's call them quantum fluctuations, or let's call them consciousness fluctuations, then what is a person? A person is a combination of fluctuating sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts, which are all entangled. And these fluctuations form is a process in time, just like the evolution of the wave function. It evolves in time. So what we call a person is a combination of fluctuations of consciousness that begins as a fertilized egg, then a zygote, then an embryo, then a baby, then a toddler, then a teenager, young adult, mature adult, old adult, all the way to dusty death. That's a process in time of entangled experiences, which are sensations, images, feelings, and thoughts in consciousness. And that which we call a person is also entangled with that which we call other persons and other beings. Other persons and other beings are also combinations of these fluctuations. Call them quantum fluctuations as a process, and or call them fluctuations of awareness as an experience. But even the process is an experience in non-local consciousness. So this is also an idea in Buddhism. You know, we are interbeings that interarise in the inter-isness. So in the matrix of existence, in the theatre of what we experience as space-time and causality, all these entangled combinations of fluctuations are interacting with each other in order to cause experience. And a lifetime is just a storyline of this process that a person is in awareness, entangled with other processes that are we call other persons and other beings, and their corresponding experiences. So reality is not only stranger than we think, it's stranger than we can think. And how is this all so infinitely correlated in experience? How do sensations like sound and light and other sensations we have, they all enter our consciousness at different speeds, but they're all correlated as one experience. So there's correlation. The quantum field is potential for manifestation. The consciousness field is potential for manifestation. The quantum field has something called the uncertainty principle. Consciousness field also has some uncertainty that is usually interpreted as governed by karma. So karma defines the statistical likelihood of the next fluctuation. And in Schrodinger's wave function, also we see statistical likelihood of the wave function into the manifestation of a space-time event. That space-time event may be a thought, it may be a sensation, it may be an image, it may be any experience as a single unit. And so are particles. They're all space-time events in consciousness. We label particles as out there, but they're space-time events in consciousness. And so too are sensations, which are entangled with all sensations, including thought. Think of your mother right now, and immediately her image will come. So that thought mother is associated with the image mother. And then as you keep thinking, perhaps an emotion will arise. So the feeling, the thought, the image are all in superposition. Okay. All sensations, all images, all feelings, all in thoughts are in superposition, entangled. And so are particles. So what's the difference? They're space-time events in consciousness. And consciousness is manifesting then as a process. And that process is a person or anything else, a book, a ring, a painting. It's all made of the essentially the same stuff. But that stuff, which is it's made of, is not ordinary stuff, it's non-stuff. And it is fluctuating as the appearance of stuff and also as the appearance of subjective experience. So pure potentiality, uncertainty, superposition, leaps of imagination, quantum leaps of imagination, where you have one set of experiences and you leap to another set of experiences without going in through the space in between. So let's try this. Think of the Empire State Building and now think of your mother. That's a leap. There's no continuity between the first experience, the thought, mother, and then whatever, Empire State Building. No connection. And yet they come from the same field. So once again, pure potentiality, superposition, uncertainty principle, quantum leaps. But in the background of all this is an organizing principle. Self-organization, self-correlation, non-local correlation, and onward evolution as a never-ending horizon. Who are we? Who's Deepak? Who is that which is listening? It's just consciousness experiencing itself as this process and the process that is listening and the process that is my computer. Everything comes from one field. And that field is infinite, borderless, incomprehensible, unimaginable, cannot be conceptualized, cannot be perceived, is irreducible. It's fundamental and it is without cause. So in the deeper reality, the very fact that I can express this, even though it seems hopelessly abstract, it doesn't to me, but it might to you appear gobbledygook. But the fact that I can express this says that the human mind is quite different from the mind of other species, in that it can, it is of course a fluctuation or a combination of fluctuations of the same field, but the human mind can actually create models out of this experience. And by creating models, it expands our experience of the virtual reality that we're in. I think I may be rambling today, but this is very difficult to express. Reality is, it's not only stranger than we think it is, it's stranger than we can think, because of the limitations of human knowing. But if we go back to the source, there's some kind of intuitive insight that everything that we are seeing and experiencing, including our bodies and everything else, including our minds actually, is a virtual reality. It's a fluctuation. It has no permanence. The only thing that's permanent is the field itself. And we are that field, and we are the knower of the field. The quantum field is a modeling of the consciousness field. Now, I know this is abstract. I know this is, you know, where's the proof? What's the evidence? All kinds of questions will arise. So if I have confused you, apologies. You know, sometimes it's good to be confused and bewildered, because that takes away the hubris and arrogance with which we have certainty about things. There's no certainty about anything, and thank God, because in the absence of uncertainty, there wouldn't be any creativity as well. Okay, my friends, that's it for today.